I'm about to, back at Navajo Rocks. I'm gonna ride a section of the trail I haven't ridden yet, called Big Mesa. And it's not on a loop, so I kind of had to park in a weird spot. And I'm gonna have to huff it back up a highway road. Well, not a highway, but a paved road. Get back to my truck, otherwise I'd have to do 20 miles today and don't have that in me. I just drove my truck down here to scope out where the trailhead kind of intersects with this road, and this road sucks. I don't know if you can see the ridges in it, but good grief. I shook every bolt on my truck loose. And there's some campgrounds out here. Good place to get murdered. I lowered my tire pressures today. So if I hit any of that sand, hopefully I get a little better traction. I was running really high pressure. I was reading some pro advice online, run high pressure on the rocks, but that really only applies to if you're running inner tubes in your tires, and so you don't get pinch flats. But since everybody's running tubeless now, less risk of it, there's zero risk of puncturing your inner tube because you don't have one. And I carry CO2 cartridge, so if I do get a what's called a tire burp, I can refill the tire. All right, so here's Big Mesa. Here's where it starts. Big Mesa. Mesa. Like a big rock, doesn't it? Or maybe a some sort of Latin dish you can order. I'll have a mesa. So this is part of the Navajo Rocks loop, and there's little trails on the loop, like Ramblin', there's a park called Coney Island, Big Lonely, and I've done all of them except this part. It was pouring down rain. Thank you. about to see some nice vista. Oh yeah. Time for me to have my first crash since shaving the skin off my knee. So they definitely came in handy yesterday. I have a good habit, I'm told, falling on my left side. If you're gonna crash your bike, you wanna do it on the left. That way it doesn't snap your derailleur hanger. Bikeless for the rest of the trail. Quicksand. Right there, just went through some quicksand. Running lower tires today. It's good to have more weight on the rear tire when you hit that stuff. Because if you get weight on the front, it's literally like water skiing. Dry. When you're moving on the bike, this you got a nice breeze on you, you know. When you stop, or you're on that rock, slick rock stuff, it's really cold and warm. Oh, I should have kept speed there. Slick rock. It's like 10 degrees hotter on this stuff. Just holds that heat and radiates it. Seems like being on AstroTurf in the summertime. Probably not as hot as the AstroTurf. I did 22 miles of mostly downhill yesterday, but still killed my legs. Alright, it's flattening out a little bit. there's the blue. Some of the trails paint them red or green, and I have trouble picking those colors up. Even with my x-ray glasses I got for Christmas. And once I see it, I see it, but peripherally, it's tougher to pick up. Take a break.